Welcome to our new video, that is the third part of communication skill 2 for class 10th. In this video, we are going to learn about the communication barriers and writing skills. Now, I will start from the communication barriers. A communication barrier is anything that prevents us from receiving and understanding the messages others that use to convey their information, ideas and thoughts. Or we can say that a communication barrier is an obstacle that prevents the receiver from receiving and understanding the message that has been sent by sender. If a message is not understood clearly, it may lead to communication gap and causing confusion and misunderstanding. So, further going to detail in communication barriers, we have to learn about the type of communication barriers. There are many barriers that hinder our ability to communicate. We will now learn about the type of the area and the various factors causing them. First one is barriers related to the formation of message. In this, lengthy or complicated message, linguistic issues, inconsistent tone or non-verbal communication are the mainly areas of the communication barriers. Next is internal barriers. Disinterest or excitement, poor listening skills, emotional barriers, difference in perception and viewpoint, bias, cultural differences are the internal barriers. External barriers, noise and other distractions, physical barriers between communicators, physical disabilities, physical barriers to non-verbal communication. These are the external barriers area. Next is measures to overcome the barriers of communication. Clarify the ideas before communication. Communicate according to the need of receiver. Consult others before communicating. Be aware of language, tone and content of message. Convey things of help and value to listeners. Ensure proper feedback. Communicate for present as well as future. Follow up communications. Be a good listener. Now, next is writing skills. So we start from basic writing skills. What are basic writing skills? Basic writing skills are an important part of communication, or writing skills are an important part of communication. Good writing skills allow you to communicate your message with clarity and ease to communicate your message to a far larger audience than through face-to-face or telephone conversation. You might be called upon to write a report, plan or strategy at work, write a grant application or press release within a volunteering role, or you may fancy communicating your ideas online via blog, and of course a well-written CV or resume with no spelling or grammatical mistakes is essential if you want a new job. These are the basic examples of writing skills. Now, the first topic of writing skill is phrase. A phrase is a words that form a unit within a sentence but is incomplete independently. A phrase lacks both the subject and the object. Type of phrases: a noun phrase acts like a noun in a sentence. An adjective phrase is bullet around an adjective and consists of objective and or articles. A verb phrase is a group of main verbs and helping verbs within a sentence. An adverbial phrase is built around an adverb by adding words before or after it. A prepositional phrase always begins with a preposition and is allowed by a noun. Now we are going to learn a new topic, that is sentences. A group of words that makes complete sense is called a sentence. The sentence must contain the subject and a predicate. Now, kinds of sentences. An assertive sentence is a sentence that states a fact. Such a sentence is a simple statement that indicates, asserts, or declares something. An imperative sentence is a sentence which gives a command, make a request, or express a wish. This type of sentence may end with a full stop or an exclamation mark. An interrogative sentence is a sentence that asks a question. An exclamatory sentence is a sentence that expresses sudden and long feelings such as surprise, wonder, pity, sympathy, happiness, or gratitude. Now, this is a graphical representation of the sentences: declarative sentence, interrogative sentence, exclamatory sentence, imperative sentence. Next is parts of sentence. Every complete sentence contains two parts. First is subject. Subject is a word or group up of words which conveys the name of the person or thing that we are asking about. Predicate. Second one, on the other hand, it is part of the sentence which contains a verb and states something about the subject. Now, next is parts of speech. Noun, naming word. Pronoun, replace a noun. Adjective, describing word. Verb, action word. Adverb, describes a verb. Preposition, shows a relationship. Conjunction, joining word. Interjection, expressive word. Okay, here the definition is given. You may please understand by the definition also. Next is articles. English has two articles. The is used to refer the specific or particular nouns. A and is used to modify non-specific or non-particular nouns. We call the definite article and an the indefinite article. When to use the? Use the before singular and plural nouns when the noun is specific. Example, the teacher I spoke to at the school was very friendly. When to use an and? When we are referring to any member of a group, we use an. It is not important which one we are talking about. Example, I want to buy a new car. There are many types of car. It does not matter yet which type I want. When not to use articles? A and the are not used with plural nouns, uncountable nouns, real nouns. Here examples are given. Plural nouns, boys like saucer. The boys in my school like saucer. Uncountable noun, pollution is a problem. Real noun, I want to visit the Spain. So we do not say I want to visit the Spain. Okay, so here is the example where the wrong thing is given and it is explaining that we do not say I want to visit the Spain. Real noun means really the things which is available. Do not use articles with real noun, the name of people or places. So the correct sentence is I want to visit Spain. Paragraph writing. In the English language, paragraph is a fundamental unit of composition. A forest of a paragraph consists of several sentences grouped together to talk about aim and subject. Thus, if paragraph is essentially a collection of sentences that relate to one central topic. Rules for writing a paragraph. Give the paragraph uniformity. Give the paragraph short. Use topic sentences. Leave out unnecessary details. End the paragraph with a concluding sentence. A paragraph is usually judged on the following criteria. First is introduction, including title. Support or explain. This is further divided into three parts: content, expression, sequencing. And last one is conclusion. A particular representation of whole chapter is given by using this mind map. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video.